We're on. Good evening. Thanks for showing up. This is the pre-show show. We are, of course, you know, Trout Fishing America. There's Keith Ovar. I'm Ezra over here. And we're happy you're here.
How many people do you have there in your room, Ezra?
23 so far.
23 people. I don't know how many are in my room. Susan's still looking for my room for me. I couldn't find my room on a bet.
So if you want to talk to us right now, if you're on YouTube, you can say, hey, because I'm actually looking at YouTube, and I think I got it.
Who's saying hey to you?
E.T. says, hey, guys. Hi, E.T.
Hi, E.T.
Ian Hayden says, hi, Keith and Ezra. They're ready for some trout.
Hey, Ian, do you know what you call a woman who is setting fire to all of her bills? Are you ready? Bernadette.
Oh, my goodness.
Thought you'd like that. Okay, fine.
Emma. Hi, it's been a very long time, fan. I've been a very long time fan. Hello, Emma.
Hi, Emma.
Listening to our music so much. Thank you. We won't be doing mine today, but we got a bunch of requests last week, and we're going to fit in as many as we could learn this week. Some of them came from a really long time ago.
They sure did. I've been diving back into the deep catalog, playing songs that were written and played by a really young Keith Grimwood. I'm going to have to summon the spirit of Keith tonight to get through this set. It's a great set. It's
fun. The History Tree Center.
What?
The History Tree Series in Katy, Texas says hi.
Kathy O'Connell says, well, I'm watching you, but I can't hear anything because I'm still on the radio. She has radio shows. Hi, Kathy. Hey, we're going to do a song for you tonight.
Yeah, yeah, we'll do this. Yeah. I can type hi, Kathy, though.
I bet you know which one.
I do.
You were the soundtrack. Okay, Erica says y'all were the soundtrack of my childhood growing up in North Carolina. Now I'm watching from Glasgow, Scotland.
Awesome.
That's where Scotland's where his family was from.
That's true. Edinburgh.
They are from, they're his family, but most of them look kind of like me, you know, kind of shorter and, you know.
Hello, Sabrina. Excited to have us in your living room this evening. Happy to be in your living room.
Let's see. Karen Schubert. Hey, how you doing? Good to see you.
Carl Bernard from Houston.
Okay, does anybody talk about anything? I mean, I can continue to say your names.
Be careful what you ask for.
No, we don't need any requests. I said we'd do some requests. Last time you guys sent me requests for about the next three sets. I swear, I want to do some songs in there, but we're just going to do a lot of requests and a couple of other ones that I put in honor of Valentine's Day and, as they call, the Valentine's Hangover. Okay, who else?
Looking at Kate McNichol, lifelong fan since 1988, watching with her five-year-old this evening.
Hi, Suits is there.
E.T. liked your joke.
Oh, she
I didn't
did.
Do that much, no. Not so much.
Hey, there's my joke. Son. My son is watching. Hey, my son. Maybe my grandson. Maybe my granddaughter. Who knows?
Question, how is the treehouse? My treehouse is, I assume, doing well. We sold our place out in Cove Creek about 3 years ago, and we sold it to a family that said they would enjoy it a whole bunch, but I have not been back to the treehouse. It's been kind of hard to go back there.
Do you know who is here?
Who would that be?
Maya is here. I'm so glad. It says, so happy you're streaming again. You were wondering last time how to pronounce my name. It's like Gaia, but with an M.
There you go.
Maya, thank you. Because I was going to say hi to you, and I went, oh my gosh, I can't remember how to say your name again. And I never want to mispronounce it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. That's awesome.
I'm making salmon tonight for dinner after this is over. I'm going to go out and I'm going to grill some salmon. Hostway is going to stick around for dinner. We get to have some grilled salmon for dinner.
Well, nobody's asking me questions. They're just saying hi. They're just saying hi. Hi, hi, hi. Well, that's good. I do have a really sad announcement of something. It's not terribly sad for anybody but me, so don't worry about it. You know, it's probably not going to affect your life one bit. But my wife came home from a doctor's visit the other day, and they had measured her height. And my wife is now 5'5½", and she towers over me. I have always been 5'5½". So I did the thing that I swore I was never going to do. Folks, I am shrinking. 5'4½".
Tough.
I'm disappearing. Just disappearing before your very eyes. Shame that I still weigh the same. That is the curious thing. I weigh the same. I'm getting shorter, but my weight is not changing. How is that possible?
I don't know. But my friend Zeke in Florida was telling me the other day for Valentine's Day, he bought his wife. He was going to buy his wife a box of chocolates.
I heard this story.
She said that she did not want chocolates this year. And he said, you know, I kind of bummed him out on two levels. One, it was always easy to buy for, and two, he likes sharing with her. So it kind of lost it on two levels. But then he decided he was going to buy a box of chocolates anyway. Bought a box of chocolates, ate them all, and then stuffed it with little bitty carrots and gave it to her. And she was not happy. And he said, the moral of that story is buy chocolates no matter what people say. That's what
Zeke said. That's good. I like it. More chocolate. Okay, let's see. Joyce is here. Joyce, hey, up in Maine.
Hey, Joyce.
Good to see you, Joyce. Matthew's here. I'm here. We got a couple of songs on that 12-string guitar for you, Matthew. It's over there somewhere.
Yes, it is.
We did have a nice Valentine's Day. Did you have a nice Valentine's Day, Ezra?
I did. I cooked a big meal the day before, and I didn't have to cook yesterday. We just ate what we had left over. It was good.
All right.
What did you have, you ask? Why, I had cauliflower bowl. I make homemade cauliflower rice and mix it up with a whole bunch of stuff. It's pretty sweet.
I like chocolate myself. Chocolate's much better. Christine, up in Ontario. There's somebody else from Ontario, too, right up here. Hey, good to see you.
Been too long since we've been to Ontario.
Sure has.
Miss it. Cold up there.
You know what, Matthew? Ezra tried playing Simon Says on the 12-string, and he can't do it. The 12-string guitar that he played that on originally was a baritone 12-string guitar, which is one of the guitars that got stolen and never showed back up. So we don't have that one. So we're not going to be able to do that song, but we will do two other songs that I know you're going to like. Hey. Hey, you guys know fair. I'm getting a bunch of requests over here. I've already told you, I got requests for the next three set lists. No, really, it's nice to have them. I'll go through again. Oklahoma is listening.
What's the strangest last-minute gig we ever played? I would say one of those gigs probably was celebrating the arrival of the 1980 Ford pickup truck line at A.C. Collins Ford in Houston, Texas on South Ritchie Road. They backed up two trucks, tailgate to tailgate. Key stood in one bed and I stood in the other. We put the PA speakers on the hoods and we played to South Ritchie Road. Like that. And nobody came except for a bunch of salesmen that were inside trying to, you know, drum up business. And they were sucking down helium balloons. And they were requesting The Gambler. And then there were some kids that wanted to hear Kiss.
They were eating ice cream on their bicycles. It was a great show. We knew that a fine career awaited us. There was no stopping us now.
We got sunburned. There's actually somewhere in this world there are pictures of that gig. That was pretty last minute.
Elaine, Houston. Hey, you guys, this is still more requests. More requests. That's great.
Well, you can just say yes to the ones that we're doing and don't even mention the ones
we're doing. No. They're watching from Midlothian. That's Kathy is watching there.
Midlothian, Texas?
Yeah.
I had friends. Penn and Louise Jones lived in Midlothian, Texas.
Well, he was into the Kennedy assassination,
he
I believe.
Was.
He was very well-read and knowledgeable and had many theories on that, as I recall.
He was there. He was a newspaper man that was there when it happened.
Yes.
And he felt that it was a conspiracy for his whole life.
He never gave it up. She was this little bit, she was even shorter than I was. And she loved Ezra. She just loved talking to Ezra. She was old, nice old lady.
I loved her back. She wrote some of the finest letters ever. They were typed on a typewriter. Paragraphs were organized and thoughtful, and there were no mistakes. She was an amazing correspondent. Another Midlothian. All right.
Under a rock was fun. I remember Under a Rock. That was great. That was here in Arkansas. The party under the rock.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha.
One of those parties, people parachuted into the party.
That was really
sweet. We should have parachuted into the party trying to drive in there. I'm a city boy at that point. And driving into Arkansas for the party under the rock, I don't know. I was pretty skeptical about it, but I did have a good time.
We're driving down dirt paths, not dirt roads. And it was right about that time that I was coming to a head of really desiring to buy a bus. There was like a 1930s bus outside of Enoch's Cafe in Shreveport, Louisiana. I wanted to buy it. It was for sale. It stayed for sale for years. And I wanted it. He said, man, we don't want that. It'd just be hard to park. It'd be a pain in the butt. And who knows what. And I thought, oh, God, it'd be so wonderful. We could put all of our dishes and food in there and take our animals with us. It'd be wonderful. And then we were going down this party on the rock thing and going down this dirt path. And I realized, had we bought that bus and had that been our transportation, there'd have been no way to get there or back. If we'd got there, we certainly wouldn't have got out.
It would have been called the party in the bus. That was what it'd be, not the under the rock, party in the bus. Which could have been fun. You never can tell.
Carl Bernard says he loves Dana's version of Buffalo Shuffle. I do too. It was such an extreme compliment to have my daughter play a song that he wrote.
I see a request that we're actually going to do. This is great.
Sweet, you win.
Christine Benson says our noses are freezing from our head down to our nose froze.
That'll be the second song.
That's the second song. We know about that one because we wrote it, and we actually still remember how to play it, I hope. Nancy, down in Florida with the family. Hey,
right.
How you doing?
Hey, Nancy and family.
Let's see. Anybody else have a question? Listening from Tennessee, that's Brian. Watching from Kerrville. Hey, folks, we're going to be at the Kerrville Folk Festival. I don't know if you know about that yet, but we're going to be there.
Going to the big board to find your date?
The
4th and 5th of June, says our wrangler, who has a mind for numbers like
the
nobody I've
The 4th and 5th of June. It's got to be here some. Oh, yeah. Here it is. Yeah. On the news side of things, we do have a new CD coming out. We did a really cool video for it, too. That's going to be a little later. April 22nd is when that comes out.
What's our all-time favorite Trout song? They vary. My stock reply is often just saying, who's your favorite child? I mean, they're all different. They really are. I like a bunch of them. I like all of them. You know, honestly, they're some are bigger than others, but I like them all.
Well, yes, you're absolutely correct, Susan. The 4th and 5th, we are going to be at Kerrville. On the June 1st, Wheatfield is going to be playing Kerrville. Ezra and I play in that band with Connie and Craig, and we're going to be doing a show there. What else? Oh, yes, the Moccasin Creek Festival in Effingham. There's one we have never played. I mean, Kerrville, we've played a lot, but Effingham, we've never played there. We stopped there for gas a lot. But never, set up the equipment.
Looks like, I can't read the first name, Jensen. Once offered Ezra $40 cash for Robert Redford, and I turned him down flat. You know, I got a lot more money for that truck out of Keith. A lot more.
I sold it for $100 when it had 540,000 miles on it. Guy wanted to buy it for a 17-year-old son. I said, what did he do wrong?
Wrap it up. She says she's pointing her finger at the air and doing this, which means we're getting close to playing.
Okay,
music.
I have to look for my last comments. My last comment. I made it. Yes, Nancy. Yes, Christine. I'll see. Matthew, you have excellent taste. It says Trout Fishing America is my favorite country music band. Thank you.
I just got to say, this bit right here, as weird and goofy as it seems, is the thing that has made live streams really great for me. It's always felt so sterile and odd looking at a camera lens, but knowing you guys are out there and having a little bit of chance to talk with you has just settled my mind. Thank you again.
Hello from Owen Sound.
Oh, who said hello from Owen Sound?
That's Lisa A. and Brent Jeffries.
I know Brent Jeffries. Hey, Brent, we miss Owen Sim.
Yes, we do.
A lot.
Okay, maybe I should pick up a bass, right?
Why don't you do it?
Okay, folks, these songs, we got a lot of requests. So when I wrote this set list out, first thing I wrote, a bunch of songs that we wanted to play because, you know, love and Valentine's Day and stuff. And then I got all your requests out and I erased all those other songs. And we're going deep in the catalog tonight, folks. Really deep.
Yes, we are. This first song we're going to start with, we wrote in Little Rock, Arkansas. We were in a hotel room together. That was when we still took trips and stayed in the same hotel room. And Keith has some words. Well, I had some music. That's what it was.
Ezra had some music, and he left, and I wrote some words while he was gone. While he was gone, the tornado sirens came on, and I thought I might never see him again. But instead, he came home, and I showed him these words, and we put it to his music, and here we go.
Standing outside in the dark, it's 3 o'clock, and I'm fumbling for my keys. How to fix that front porch light? Maybe tomorrow I'll remember that I left. When I remember that I won't, maybe it's wasting time the way I'm spending mine. Guess I should get something done while everyone's asleep. Claim that time for me, and it's too dark to be mowing that lawn. Picking up pork chop bones left on the floor by my bed dog, mumbling to my savior. Take a look in the fridge, grab some Tostitos and picante sauce, and I'm headed for my chair. Maybe it's wasting time the way I'm spending mine. Guess I should get something done while everyone's asleep. I claim that time for me, and it's too dark to be mowing that lawn. Enough of that TV Jones, turn it off and crawl in the bed with my dead wife, fumbling with my sheets. Turn out the light, turn over and kick out my cat. It's a sleepy time cartoon. Maybe it's wasting time the way I'm spending mine. Guess I should get something done while everyone's asleep. I claim that time for me, and it's too dark to be mowing that lawn. So this is going to be the second song. The second song we promised to Christine Benson was going to be about Alberta.
Do you know, this year, for the first year, Ezra decided that he didn't want to drive anymore in the ice and the snow. And he knows that I can't do that because I am really terrible at that sort of stuff. I can drive all night and stay awake, but you put a little ice on that road, we will be going sideways. So anyway, he didn't want to do it this year, and we took January and February off so we could avoid situations like this one.
So nice.
When that big traffic jam happened and they were on there for hours and hours, we saw it on TV and better on TV. But we had a great time this trip.
Yeah. down to my toes froze when sliding in the white snows down the streets of Calgary. We saw sun doves, stayed all day till we saw moon doves, home to a fire of burning birch logs, a night of quiet revelry. It's not always this cold, guess we got lucky this time, but 35 below's impressive for a southern boy, and memories like this will always be frozen in time. Oh, my nose froze, from my head down to my toes froze. It was cold in that Alberta snow, wouldn't have headed any other way. Tell me stories about your dry rain. I see the lightning and I smell the rain. Falls but never hits the ground. Hear how the snow squeaks. Tires are grinding and groaning down city streets. People out and about and on their feet. Put on those goober boots and go. It's not always this cold, guess we got lucky this time, but 35 below's impressive for a southern boy, and memories like this will always be frozen in time. Oh, my nose froze, from my head down to my toes froze. It was cold in that Alberta snow, wouldn't have headed any other way. Frosted forest, wind sculpted first face, and the bighorn sheep clamming all over the place. Oh, my nose froze, from my head down to my toes froze, went sliding in the white snows down the streets of Calgary. Oh, my nose froze, from my head down to my toes froze. It was cold in that Alberta snow, wouldn't have headed any other way. Wouldn't have headed any other way. That was for our Canadian friends up there. Speaking of Canadian friends, how many of y'all have seen Letterkenny? That's a Canadian show. I doubt that it's actually really true. I think it's probably an exaggeration of Canadian culture. I do, but it feels good to watch it anyway. We're about to make Keith turn work. Into young Keith. We're going to make him work. This is the Valentine's Day hangover show.
We got three or four love songs coming at you right now.
This will be fun.
This one's a song called Love, Love. Let me move things around. I got to get room here to be young.
Two, three, four.
It's just chance. And love doesn't even ask if you can dance. You might pick, but you can't always choose. You might win, but you sure can't lose. Love gets waves and then it bad reviews. You gotta love, love.
Keith was noticing the other day that the love songs that we sing are pretty different from each other. That's a Keith love song, and it's going to be an Ezra love song. See if you can tell the difference.
Okay.
You got it? Two, three. From your feet to your head, there's blue jeans and a t-shirt, pair of socks and a pair of worn out shoes. And I love your face without a trace of makeup. It's a good thing, cause it's something you don't use. And in the wintertime, it's sweatpants and a sweatshirt, some heavy socks and those same old worn out shoes. And I meant what I said when I told you that I loved you. I meant it then, and lover, I still do. Looks like a long straight line from the place where we started. I can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be. And when I look out to see where this is going, I can only see as far as you and me. I can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be. Your eyes sparkle and shine like emeralds on the ocean. Just a look, I'd do anything you'd say. I'd waste a fortune just to have you near me, but you hold tight to what I'd throw away. Looks like a long straight line, twists and turns and troubles. We followed it directly to this place. With the passing of time, the feelings just run deeper, deeper than the laugh lines that have etched upon your face. From morning to night, we're always keeping busy. We fill every day with more than we can do. And I meant what I said when I told you that I loved you. I meant it then, and lover, I still do. Looks like a long straight line from the place where we started. Can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be. And when I look out to see where this is going, I can only see as far as you and me. I can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be. I can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be.
That is really pretty, Ezra.
Thank you.
Sharp and stunning contrast, I'd like to offer this next song, which has been a request for a while. Folks, okay, I'm going to dig down for this one. This is from back in 1990, I believe.
We were playing in Monroe, Louisiana, at a place called The Depot, which is right next to the railroad tracks over there.
True story, folks. We were playing up there. Crowd, it's packed. Dance floor, packed. We're up there playing. We're having a good night. And I get off the stage, and this woman comes over to talk to me. And she has on lots of makeup, and makeup and stuff. And I, you know, makeup, whatever. And I start listening to her as she's talking. But it's really loud, and her mouth is moving. And I could not understand a word. And then it stopped moving. And I thought, oh, my gosh, I'm going to have to say something. And I said, could you repeat that, please? And then she started moving her mouth and talking again. I did not hear a single word that woman said. Her mouth was just so interesting.
You just stood there and talked to her all day, wouldn't you?
I would. I would have listened all day without hearing a word.
Two, three, four.
Lost in her lips. I'm getting lost in her lips. I'm losing track of the conversation. Fluorescent clock. Just discovered his lips. The expedition would have ended up in Mexico. No. Lost in her lips, downtown New York in her lips. I tried to lift my eyes with no success. Got on with the transfer, and now I miss my stop. Bus driver is waving, pointing me out to a cop. What am I saying? Hey, does it matter? What is she saying? Why should I care? What could be more interesting than staring at these lips, failing to communicate? Lost in her lips, I'm cooking breakfast with her lips, scrambling my sentences and by. Sitting at my table, there's coffee in my drink. It's difficult to concentrate, impossible to think. I ask them questions to watch them answer. Could you repeat that? So I might watch again. Be more
Ezra love song. This is for Kathy O'Connell.
Hopefully you're off the radio, but well, now I hope you're still on the radio, but maybe quit broadcasting and listen to this beautiful love song.
The mountains never crumble, and the rivers don't run dry. The oceans keep on pounding, the sun stays in the sky. If apples keep on falling, and 3 and 2 is 5, I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes right. If the world keeps on turning and snow keeps falling white, fire keeps on burning, daylight follows every night. If flowers bloom in springtime and birds remember how to fly, I'll still be loving you no matter what goes right. No matter what goes right, I will still be loving you. No matter what goes right, I will stand by you. And when couples fight their troubles, it unites their hearts. When the good times roll, they can drift apart. I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes right. When all this work is over and my ship comes sailing in, you'll always be my lover, you'll always be my friend. If the stars up in the heavens will keep on shining and clear and bright, I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes right. No matter what goes right, I will still be loving you. No matter what goes right,
I will stand by you. And when couples fight their troubles, it unites their hearts. When the good times roll, they can drift apart. I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes wrong. Unites their hearts. When the good times roll, they can drift apart. I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes right. I'll still be loving you, no matter what goes right.
Pause right there and let Ezra get over to his 12-string guitar. Matthew, just wanted to hear, let you know, Ezra's now picking up his 12-string. Matthew always requests 12-string songs, and he sends us lists of songs he wants to hear on the 12-string guitar.
I just want to say thank you to Matthew. You never know what your influences are going to be, and certainly making sure this 12-string was functional in this band was partly Matthew's fault.
We started working on these songs, and man, they both sound great on the 12 string. We wouldn't have even thought about doing them on 12 without Matthew suggesting it.
That's right.
Thanks, Matthew.
Mostly I'm just following my feet. Now I don't plan a lot. I like surprises in my day. I don't mind sitting all alone. It gives me time to think, to dream of houses in the trees. Dreaming I see bridges spanning spaces between red oak trees, connecting houses in the leaves. Someday my room will rock and shiver with the wind. One day I'll eat my dinner in a tree. Comes a time when you have to work, the time to roll the sleeves up on your shirt. And sometimes when you think of what's involved, it can hurt your head. And labor of love can be the hardest labor. Dreaming, building bridges, spanning spaces between red oak trees, connecting houses in the leaves. Someday my room will rock and shiver with the wind. One day I'll write my songs up in a tree. Thank you. If you find me following my feet far out on the limb, forgetting things I should have known, you can laugh, but don't be surprised by the blank stare in my eyes. I'm just making plans for my new dreaming. I see bridges spanning spaces between red oak trees, connecting houses in the leaves. Someday my room will rock and shiver with the wind. One day I'll eat my pie up in the sky. Thank you.
Nice. Okay. Going to continue on some requests. We have not always played only original music. We still don't play all original music. We play whatever we want to play. We even play the songs no other band will play. That's a quote, too. We've had some requests to do some cover songs, and we'd like to do a couple of these covered songs for you. Some of the old days, we just, you know, hit the bars and just played covered music and had a really good time doing it. Here's a Cat Stevens song.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to learn. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something's going on. So take your time, think a lot, think of everything you've got, 'cause you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not.
Well, how can I try to explain when I do, it turns away again. It's always been the same, same old story. From the moment I could talk, I was ordered to listen. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away. I know I have to go.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax and take it slowly. You're still young, well, that's your fault. There's so much you have to go through. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy.
All the time that I've cried, keeping all the things I knew inside. It's hard, but it's hard to ignore them.
You go ahead,
if they were right, I'd agree. Alone. But it's them they know, not me. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away. I know I have to go.
I'm going steady with Iron or Betty. She's going steady with me. We receive our mail at the same mailbox. We watch the same TV. I got rug burns on my elbows, but she's got them on her knees. Yeah, I'm going steady with Iron or Betty. She's going steady with me. Picking my brains out, I've been working at the hardware store. I've been trying to keep a chicken in the window to keep away the wolf from the door. And Betty been working at the iron ore mine, I'm bringing home energy. Yeah, I'm going steady with Iron Ore Betty. She's going steady with me.
Mm-hmm.
have been speaking in English. She's been speaking in English too. Yeah, we always speak the same language, and we always get it through. And I met her at a dance at the Union Hall, dancing to Daddy G. Yeah, I'm going steady with Iron or Betty. She's going steady with me. By mail at the same mailbox, we watch the same TV. I got rug burns on my elbows, but she's got them on her knees. Yeah, I'm going steady with Ann or Betty. She's going steady with me, that's right. Now I'm going steady with Ann or Betty. She's going steady with me.
All right. Song, of course, from John Prine. And that other one, that Cat Stevens song, was called Father and Son, in case you didn't know. Oh.
I have a visual aid here for this next song as I hold this painting up. This painting has hung in my house since I was a very little boy. We had friends, the Donahues, Eve and Bill Donahue, and they had a son named Christopher Donahue and Jessica and a bunch of Donahue kids.
You have to explain your neighborhood. It was a bohemian neighborhood. Explain it to me.
It was indeed. Now, Eve Donahue was the woman that painted this. She and my mom both would sell their hair from time to time to make ends meet. Both of them had really long hair, and they would sell it to wig makers to make ends meet. We lived in a kind of a tough neighborhood, a bad neighborhood. It was good enough for me, I guess, but anyway, Eve was a painter and a kind of a beatnik kind of woman. And most of her paintings were naked women in the Garden of Eden with snakes and apples and stuff like that. And I thought they were awesome. And Mom told me we were going to get one of Eve's paintings. And I was so excited we were going to have one of those hanging in our house. And then we got this right here, this painting right here. This is not an Eve Donahue that I remembered, but it was a picture of where I grew up. Now, I grew up the first part of my life in Baltimore, Maryland. And I believed for the longest time that this was the intersection of Park Avenue and Tyson Street. Went back there with a Google map a few years ago and looked at the building at Park Avenue and Tyson Street. And guess what? It wasn't that building. I don't know what it was. But Park Avenue and Tyson Street were very different streets. Park Avenue in Baltimore was probably where this was where all the businesses were. Tyson Street is where all the artists and their children lived. And you'd walk down Tyson Street, which is one of those little side streets that came off of a wrought iron building. No, it's not. There's a name for it. Anyway, that side street, there would always be these.
It's like a wedge. It's like a wedge.
What is it called? Something iron building.
Flatiron,
there you
Flat
go.
Flatiron building. We're going to have to change the name of this song, I think.
No, we aren't.
Rural Route 12 and Main Street. Okay, just.
All right, let's see. This pick doesn't feel good. I'm going to throw this one away.
Yeah.
Maybe this one feels better. This song is called Park Avenue and Tyson Street. For as long as I recall, there's this picture on my wall. Of a place where two roads meet, Park Avenue and Tyson Street. Part of my life frozen in time, in a gaslight with a blue line.
I can go back there anytime. Marble stairs and red brick rows look the same each way you go. Park Avenue runs north and south, while Tyson Street lives hand to mouth. Part of my life frozen in time, in a gaslight with a blue line. I can go back there anytime. Artist on the sidewalk, painting in pairs, making ends meet, she's selling her hair. Captured in a frame, take me back there. Streets, and no business to complete. For as long as I recall, there's this picture on my wall. Part of my life, frozen in time, in a gaslight with a blue line. I can go back there anytime. Part of my life, frozen in time, in a gaslight with a blue line. I can go back there anytime. I can go there, I can go back there anytime.
That song is so hypnotic. While you're playing it, you cannot be hypnotized, because if you play one wrong chord, you will never catch up. That's for anybody that is ever trying to play that song.
Hey.
Advice.
What do they have to say on the big board, Keith?
I don't know. Let's
see what anybody's saying.
Okay.
You take a look at yours. I'll see if I can catch up to mine.
Oh, there's nothing on mine. Wait, there's one. Hey, don't quit your day job. Wait.
Mariah Stack from Olympia, Washington. I have emailed you from time to time. You never write back, and you never say hi. I'm making that up. We're doing good, and our dogs and cats are doing good, too. I have a dog. It's a boxer. Her name is Millie, and she is in your face all the time, all the time.
Also like to recognize a couple of people here in the studio. That is Susan Billimick, our wrangler over there, keeping me straight on the big board and stuff. And back there, there's Josue back there doing the sound. Nice, congratulations, and thank you, man. Thank you. Good job. Let's see. Love that song. Oh, yeah.
Patrick Walsh loves that picture. I like that picture, too. Now, you know, I was disappointed as a kid, but as I get older, I find deeper meaning in it. Craig Calvert, also, by the way, Craig Calvert with Wheatfield helped us write that song. That was a three-way song, right?
Did he really?
He sure did.
Okay. good. No wonder. Wait. My live chat is very limited. It used to be large. Let's see. Oh, Nancy says they're having boiled shrimp and stone crab with corn on the cob tonight. And she didn't write, but, and you're not. That's what she should have said.
We got grilled salmon and asparagus over here at this house. So, you know, it'll work.
Okay, folks. It's time to go way back. In our younger days, we had to sing cover songs. And when it came time for Bob Seger, that was my job. You've heard our love songs. Ones that he sings are really pretty, and I sing Bob Seger a little bit. But the lyrics were troubling me. The opening lyrics to this song, I don't know if you know them, but if you do, think about it. You know I cannot sing that. But being a creative songwriter, I have written a new verse. Too short and could have lost a few pounds. Tight pants, points, hardly renowned. She was a dark-haired beauty with big brown eyes. Points all her own sitting way up high. Way firm and high. Outback's cornfields where the woods got heavy. The backseat of my 60 Chevy. Working on mysteries without any clues. Working on her night moves. Trying to make some fun page time in news. Working on her night moves. In the summertime. Sweet, the summertime, summertime. We were in love, although far from it. We won't search for some pie in the sky summit. And we were just young and restless and bored, living by the sword. And we steal away every chance we could to the back, the alley, the trusty woods. I used her, she used me, neither one cared. We were getting our share, working on the night moves, trying to lose those awkward teenage blues, working on some night moves in the summertime. Sweet summertime, summertime. We felt the lightning. We waited on the thunder. We waited on the thunder. Well, I woke last night to the sound of thunder. How far off I sat in the wonder. Started humming a song from 1962. Ain't it funny how the night moves? When you just don't seem to have this much to lose. Strange how the night moves. With autumn closing in.
Night moves.
There you go.
Hot dog.
I can't wait to see what anybody says about that. Yeah, the original lyrics, look them up. You look them up. You'll know why I can't see it. Certainly not at 5'4" and a half. I certainly can't. Okay, what's next?
That's a whole inch, man.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
We're going to switch roles here. I get to sing a Keith love song.
Hey.
You know, these are love songs from different times.
I would never sing this song. Never. But this guy knows the song and does it great.
I'd love to sing it. Let's see. Are you ready?
Yeah. Sing along, folks.
If you're down and confused and you don't remember who you're talking to, concentration slip away, cause your baby is so far away. And there's a rose in the distant love, and the eagle flies with the dove. And if you can't be with the one you love, honey, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with. Don't be angry, don't be sad, don't start crying over good times you might have had. Cause there's a girl right next to you, and she's just waiting for something to do. And there's a rose in the twisted love, and the eagle flies with the dove. And if you can't be with the one you love, honey, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with. All right. Love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with. Now turn your heartaches right into joy, cause she's a girl and you're a boy. Let's get it together, come on, make it nice. I ain't gonna need any more advice, cause there's a rose in the fisted love, and the eagle flies with the dove. And if you can't be with the one you love, honey, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with. All right.
The deafening silence at the end of these songs. It's just like the old days when we played and nobody was there. Remember that, Ezra? We'd play and, you know.
Never forget it.
Hey, folks, we got two more songs for you. I want to thank you so much for being here. It is a pleasure playing music for you. We love it. Absolutely love it. I'm supposed to talk during this song, but there's things I'm not supposed to say. Like, I'm not supposed to say what a beautiful song this is, and Ezra wrote it all by himself and stuff like that. Because every time I do, he messes it all up.
Swear,
but not this time.
Not this time.
Not this time.
Shall we?
Wow. I'm still easing out of the energy of that last one. Let me get a drink.
Take a breath. Take a breath. I'll take one, too.
What are you doing this week, Ezra?
Let's see, what am I doing this week? I'm going to go visit my great nephew.
Congratulations, Dylan. Hello, Graham. Welcome to the world.
Graham is my great nephew's name.
You'll be seeing some birdie too, won't you?
I'll be seeing some of my granddaughter.
Your granddaughter.
I will. And what else? There are plans for this week. Though right now, still settling for what we just did, I can't think of them.
Well, I probably will see my grandson and my granddaughter and my son. And maybe see some people. We'll probably get together and play some music.
Yes, we will.
We always do. We do every day, pretty much. You ready?
Yeah, two, three. I know you're hurting. Baby, I'm hurting too. Sometimes it seems fighting the only thing we do, but this is for certain, this is for true. The very best thing that ever happened in my life is you. I know you work hard. Baby, I work hard too. Sometimes we need to step back, make time for me and you. That thing that we're needing, you won't find on TV, you can't buy it in the store. It's something that we make for free. The wind is blowing through the trees. There's frosting in the morning and color on the leaves. The crows are calling, laughing in the sky. The season will be over in the blinking of an eye. Frosting in the morning, the color on the leaves. Crows are calling, laughing in the sky. The season will be over in the blinking of an eye. Come sit with me, baby. Let's build a fire. Wrap ourselves in a blanket. We'll talk till we're tired. But this is for certain, this is for true. The very best thing that ever happened in my life is you. The very best thing that ever happened in my life is you.
So peaceful.
It has gone quickly, hasn't it?
It has gone quickly. Should I look one more time and see if there's anybody talking to me and telling me something? Oh. Let's see. Hi, it's me, Patrick. Wait. And thank you so much for being here. That's good. That's good. Probably be writing a newsletter in the next few days and sending that out. Who knows? We should have written one already, but we haven't. Sorry about that. Check the calendar. We're going to hit the road in April. We're going to have a new CD out, and we're going to be touring around with that at the end of April. Be sure to check it out. Kerrville Folk Festival is booked. Moccasin Creek Festival in Effingham, first time in. That'll be fun. Okay, it's time to rock out and say goodnight.
1, 2, 3, 4.
My baby likes
Justin Bieber.
My baby likes
Kenny G.
My baby likes
Fru Fru Comfort.
My baby likes
a champagne.
What can I say?
So much. We have been Trout Fishing America. We will continue to be Trout Fishing America. See you next time.